The Holy Spirit is a personal being. He has a mind. He has a will. He has feelings. And do not bring sorrow to God's Holy Spirit by the way you live. Remember, He has identified you as His own, guaranteeing that you will be saved on the day of redemption. That's Ephesians 4:30. This is a startling reality. The Holy Spirit can be grieved by our actions. The way we live can hurt Him. Now, with this in mind, those who love the Holy Spirit must ask the question, what grieves the Holy Spirit? Whatever contradicts the nature or the Word of God grieves the Holy Spirit, especially when such contradictions are lived through God's own children. Disobedience to the Word of God grieves the Holy Spirit. Ungodly thoughts grieve the Holy Spirit. When we prioritize entertainment over prayer, we grieve the Holy Spirit. When we ignore His gentle voice, we grieve the Holy Spirit. When we're more committed to interacting on social media than we are to reading the Bible, we grieve the Holy Spirit. When we allow anger to get the best of us, lust to control us, and fear to dominate us, we grieve the Holy Spirit. When we place our political preferences over God's truth, when we hold grudges against fellow believers, when we live contrary to what we preach, we grieve the Holy Spirit. When we disconnect from the gathering of believers, when we twist the scriptures to excuse our own compromise, when we withhold the gospel from those who need to hear it, we grieve the Holy Spirit. Sin grieves the Spirit. Compromise grieves the Spirit. Spiritual apathy grieves the Spirit. So let us become people who know the Word. Let us learn what breaks His heart, that we might not grieve the Holy Spirit. I'm David Diga Hernandez, and that is your Moment of Truth. Thank you for watching Encounter TV. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell. Also, help us spread the gospel of Jesus Christ in the power of the Holy Spirit. Make a one-time donation or become a monthly supporter by clicking on the donate link now.